Today's video is going to give you a simple VBA solution to the dynamic dependent drop-down list reset problem. Let me explain. If you have a dependent drop-down list like I have right here, in the first list, I'm going to select, instead of productivity, I'm going to select a game div. Now notice the value inside my dependent list, the value in the cell doesn't reset. I still see Venkal. And Venkal here belongs to the productivity division. I should see a value that is under game div. But once I activate the list, so when I click here, then I see the correct list. I see Fighter, Cryptis, which are the apps that belong to the game division. Now again, if I select Fighter and then I switch to Utility, I still see Fighter until I click here and then I select an app from this list. In this video, I'm going to show you a quick VBA solution that resets the dependent drop-down list. Now, if you're wondering how to create this dependent drop-down list in the first place, I have another video on this, and I'm going to put the link to it in the cards and in the description below the video. I also have another video that has a VBA-free approach to this, and it uses form controls, so form control combo boxes, instead of data validation. But now let's take a look at the VBA approach. Now, it's very simple. All we have to do is to put the word please select in this cell the moment we change the value of the first cell. This makes sure that the values we see here are not going to be inconsistent. Now, to get this to be automatic, so every time this value in the cell changes, this is reset, we need to attach this to an event. And Excel has a lot of worksheet and workbook events, and I cover that in more detail inside my VBA course. But here we're going to use a simple event with a simple macro to get this to reset. So first off, I need to bring up Visual Basic Editor. Now you can do it with the shortcut key Alt F11, but because we're going to be on this sheet anyhow, I can just right mouse click here and click on View Code. This automatically brings up the VBA editor, and it also makes sure I'm inside the correct sheet, right? So you have to be sure that you're putting that event, that macro, inside the correct sheet. So you can see my sheet name is list, and that's the name that I see right here. Now, from the first drop-down selection, I need to select worksheet. By default, I see this selection change event. Now, selection change occurs, so it runs, every time I make a selection. So if I click here, I would run any macro that I have inside that selection change procedure. Now let me quickly demonstrate that. We can see that selection change has a variable called target as range. So I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna do message box, and let's just get the address of target. Okay, so when I click here, I see F11. Right, so you can see that my message box macro is running every time I click somewhere. I could attach the macro to reset this every time I click on this, but I don't want that. I only want this to reset every time the value in the first list changes. There is another event for that, and that's called the change event. So I don't need a selection change. Instead, I need a change event. So let's just copy and paste this here and remove the other one. Now check this out. If I click here, the macro is not running, but the moment I input something, it runs, right? So every time the cell value is changed, it runs. Now, I also don't want this to run every time any cell value is changed. I only want it to run every time this cell value changes, right? So it's the cell that holds my first dropdown. So I'm going to restrict it to that by using an if. I'm going to check if the address of target, right, so that's the cell, that's the active cell, if its address equals, so in this case it's G4, then let's just close this with endif. I want to change the value of my dependent list, so that's G6. So let's just do range G6.value equals please select. Okay, let's do some dot, dot, dot. And that's it, right? So let's try this. I'm going to go and change this. It says, please select. Okay, I make a selection. I go and change this here. Please select. Now this macro doesn't run if I input in other cells. It only runs if the value in this cell changes. So this makes sure whatever app name that you see on the bottom list is going to belong to the division that you see on the first list. Otherwise, you have to make a selection. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to this channel if you want to get updates when I post new videos here.